Okay. Stream is working. In this case, I can give the go. Oh, fuck. Okay. Wait a second. Alright, so hello and welcome to the last stint of the DS 24 Hours of Nürburgring Lobby 1. We have had some crazy racing here, we had some drama and lead changes, so many of them. Now we have Rotec from DLL3 in the lead of the race. If we look at the quick result, which by the way is not the official result that we will have at the end, but as of now, as of the calculations from now, DLL3 is leading with the Rotec in the car, 2 minutes and 5 seconds in front of F1 Dennis of WSR. In position 3 we have RRC2 with Paul GT123, who will be driving the 2 hour stint. He has driven in the stint before, but since the stint length is 2 hours, I think it is okay that he drives this stint as well. Unfortunately, we had an issue that the driver that wants to drive in this stint can't drive, or doesn't want to drive, or doesn't, yeah, he can't drive. So this needed to be changed. Then in position 4, and we can see the livery now, is a FGR Super GT from FGR, and we also need to say that FGR has now unveiled the new livery. They wanted to unveil the new livery in this event. They asked to promote this in a video, but we couldn't give. We offered them that they can do this, but they unveiled the livery somewhere else. And now let's look at the new livery. This is probably also the reason why they disconnected, so that they can repaint the car. I think for once this can be allowed here. Now Super GT already gained 2 positions. He's on a mission. He wants to solidify the 4th place or even go higher and maybe climb up to the podium. This would only be possible if Paul GT has a miserable stint, because RRC2 is in position 3 at the moment. Then F1 Dennis for WSR, very consistent drive. All of their drivers have been great and have shown great performances. Paul is falling back a bit. He's now fighting with TSR Sakura, or Marco, who has gone past Paul now. For Paul, Sakura is not a direct opponent, and against Super GT he must he has a 2 minute gap, so he shouldn't fall back more than 2 minutes, otherwise this could be a problem. Then in position 6 we have DLL Charles with the Toyota FT1. He has come back from the real life 12 hours of Nürburgring event, and is now driving the last stint. He has also driven in stint 5, and then he has streamed stint 6. So thank you very much for helping out and making this event possible. Behind we have Eddie, and we have Poctavian, who made a little mistake and fell back to position 11. Now in the last position. Nuschel with the Toyota Supra GT500 in 10th place. Unfortunately, RC1 have had a miserable race. First stint, couldn't drive in the first stint. Then the second stint, so many mistakes that the driver gave up. In the third stint, many mistakes. In the fourth stint, even more mistakes. Fifth stint was reasonably well. The sixth stint was okay, not good, but at least not atrocious. So yeah, they are in last position, position 11, unfortunately, with only 1 minute 20 to GTF3, so there is a possibility to maybe gain another place. Then also Poctavian also had one stint where they couldn't drive, apparently due to RS Flash having internet issues. He was there at the beginning, but couldn't rejoin the lobby later on. It was classified in the quick result as a 18 minute gap. This could change, we don't know. Maybe it will be changed to a lower gap. We will see. Then Magix in the Corvette is in position 10, the last position which would still validate points, or at least more than 1 point. Nuschel against Poctavian, and Poctavian pushes Nuschel out of the way. That wasn't very nice, and also was unnecessary. Then we have the all GTF teams in a formation. We have Eddie in 7th, we have Schaefer in 8th, Magix in 9th. All following Charles. And yeah, due to the stint only being 2 hours, this will make strategies a bit less complicated. We will either see a 2-stop with pit stops in laps 5 and 10. And what we also could see would be pit stops in lap 4, 8 and 12, or maybe 3, 7 or 11. That's one of these possibilities. The main point is that we will either see 2 stops or 3 stops. I don't think that we will see any other strategy working out. Super GT now in the lead. He has to make up a gap of 2 minutes. And with the McLaren, he has a good car, which is good on fuel and is also very fast. Super GT, one of the fastest drivers in the field. And unfortunately, they had a disconnect. Unfortunately, the disconnect came at the point where we won't restart the stint. For that we would consider to restart the stint, it would have need to happen in lap 1. But unfortunately, it happened in lap 2 with about 13 minutes on the clock. Very unfortunate for FGR, because the performance was great up to that point. In the background, we see many overtakes. Sakura has gone past Dennis. Paul GT has gone past Dennis. Then we see Sakura overtaking Rotec. Also, Paul overtaking Rotec. Paul on the outside wanted to take a look at Sakura, but decided to not be aggressive and to let him go and maybe attack at the later point. The background, Rotec doesn't need to risk anything. He only needs to bring the car home without damage. That will be his main goal, and I don't think he will take any unnecessary risk that could harm the mission. Sorry. Then Poktavian has overtaken all GTF cars and is now in P7. Nuschel needs a bit to come up to pace. Obviously, you're saving fuel a bit. We can't say this with the GTF Armada. Okay, maybe for Eddie. Maybe Eddie is saving a bit. I think he might be able to go for 5 laps. Schaefer, it will be difficult for him to go for 5 laps. And Magix definitely won't go 5 laps. He will be on a 3 stop. Super GT has been able to drive 8-minute lap times. I think 8:01 was his fastest lap, and the fastest lap of the race, at least from what I have seen, was from Paul GT in the last stint, where he drove an 8:00.2. That's only a second slower than qualifying time, the best one, from Enzo Ferrari. Yeah, it sounds strange to say Enzo Ferrari when they're driving a McLaren. Little drift from Super GT through this corner, but was able to catch it. Sakura, very good fuel economy. Mazda is a very efficient car, also good on tires, should be considered more often, obviously. Then Paul, definitely not going for the 2-stop, he will be going for the 3-stop. He still needs to risk a bit, because although the gap is only 2 minutes to Super GT, he has to conserve it so that even if the calculation was wrong from the gaps, that the podium is still possible. This was a podium position for RC would be important, because then the streak of podium positions in the ES races would still continue, because in every major event that the DES had since RRC joined, they were always able to grab a podium position, at least in one class. Not always in at the top class, but sometimes in the lower class, sometimes in the higher class, but in the lower class, well, no podium. We are Paul. We can see that Paul is looking a bit tired. He's not doing the same pace, not doing the same lap times as before. He is a bit more cautious this time. I don't think he wants to risk anything here. And Marco, as we know him, collected, good pace, good tire management, good fuel economy. Still thankful that he helped me out in the Petit Le Mans race, where we secured second position in the GT class, which continues the podium streak for the Ferrari. Anyway, let's look at the rear. We have Charles in front of Eddie, then Schäfer and Magix. Octavian has made a mistake and has damage now. This could harm his strategy. If it would have happened in lap 3, this would be no problem, but unfortunately the crash happened in lap 2, so he now needs to decide, will he go for a 3 stop, or will he try to continue with the 2 stop, or does he even go a completely different strategy? Because the plan definitely was to go for a 2 stop. Eddie now with the mistake. Where do I have? Oh, here it is. We probably won't see it. Yeah, the mistake already happened. We can't look that much back, unfortunately. Now both drivers with damage. Nuschel seems to have a bit of trouble to heat up the tires. And seems to be on a completely different strategy than the others. Saving a lot of fuel. It looks to me that he might even try to go for 6 laps. Yeah, maybe not. No, I don't think so. He's on the 2 stop. 5 laps per stint. Unfortunately, most drivers of the Supra have had miserable races, and this is also due to the car being very very hard on bumps. It's just not a good car for a bumpy track, and this has taken out the drivers more often than they wished that to happen. Eddie with the BMW does not have the speed to come close to Poctavian, whereas Nuschel is closing in. The speed difference is 16 kph or maybe 10 mph. So the gap is closing down quite rapidly. I think the lap time from Nuschel will be okay. Probably faster than my fastest lap in the previous stint, but I was going for six lap stints, so this is hardly comparable. Poctavian and Eddie, yeah, both were on a 2 stop, and now they need to change to the 3 stop. Refueling, repairing the damage. Although Eddie has refueled considerably less. He's now looking for 4 lap stint. So he wants to pit in lap 6. And then he wants to do 1 5 lap stint and another 4 lap stint. Whereas Poctavian could do the 5 lap stint now and maybe then go for 2 4 lap stints. GT 2.2 seconds in front of Sakura, so the gap is staying the same. Sakura with the 8.031. This is a pretty good lap time. Paul is following with the same pace, but with considerable more tire wear and more fuel consumption. So, yeah, Sakura can... Whoa! Paul with a slide, but was able to catch it again. So yeah, Sakura is able to go this pace much more effective and with much less tire wear and fuel consumption. So he will be doing a two-stop strategy compared to Paul, who's going for the three-stop. Sure, there are a little bit shorter pit stops for Paul to do. But even if he wants to go this fast, it will be difficult to catch the others. But again, that's that's not his main target. I think his main target is just to secure the podium position. And then there would still be a little bit of a happy ending for RRC after so many mishaps in this race. For RX also would be a great final stint. Dennis is now in P4, he has overtaken Rotec. DLL is on a streak. they have won in the 6 hour for Watkins Glen race with was it Flipsy and Simits, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I think it was Flipsy and Simits. Then in the Petit Le Mans race, Rotec and Charles won in the hyperclass, in the hypercar class. And now DLL is leading again at the 24 hours of Nürburgring, Lobby 1. They have managed to qualify 3 cars for this lobby. So the performance was great. Although you might have thought that maybe DLL 1 or DLL 2 would have been performing as well or even better than at DLL3, but the team of Rotec and as also Johnny was pretty effective on this in this race. And although Semitz had did not have a good stint, and although Friese did also not have the best of stints, collectively they made the least mistakes and also had I wouldn't say luck, but they did not have technical issues. I think it's compared to WSR in P2, which also had no technical problems, but if you look at RRC, they had one stint where the driver did stop and give up. Then FGR had a disconnect very early on in lobby 6, in stint 6. And DLL1 also had a lobby where they couldn't drive, also lost another 18 minutes. So yeah, DLL of course with a very good performance in the collective and also not hit with any trouble. I'm happy that I don't drive in this alien lobby. Hello Freezy. Then we have Flipsy. Rotec really playing it safe. Honestly, I never thought the McLaren will perform so well. I wouldn't say I'm surprised, because the McLaren would have been one of the cars which I personally would have driven or liked to, or would have liked to drive. I would certainly have liked it much more than the Supra, because the McLaren is just a well-balanced MR car, has good tire wear, is considerably fast, has good BOP, and also good tire wear, good fuel consumption. It's a car you would want to drive for Nürburgring. I thought BRZ will win. They could have won, but the one stint where nobody could drive made it hard. Yes, obviously. Flash wanted to drive, and as soon as the lobby started, he was disconnected. So we started new, but unfortunately Flash still couldn't join because of lobby issues or internet issues on his side, where he couldn't do much. Super GT with the 8:55. Wow. Massive. That's good pace here. Paul cannot go the same pace. Quite a bit slower. But yeah, tires won't last much longer here. He needs to pit in this lap. You can already see that he gets understeer quite a lot. He's losing time in corners. Dennis. Tyler looks much, much better on his car. Fuel consumption is okay. He's also on a three-stop strategy. Rotec definitely on the two-stop. Then we have Magix in P6. But his tires look atrocious after three laps. Obviously, the late morning session is pretty hard on the tires. Schaefer looks much better on tires. And also a bit better on fuel. But not too much. Then we have Charles, very good tire wear. He's obviously saving. He wants to go for the two-stop strategy. Usually the FT1 was a car that was driving with the four-lap stint. We still have more than 95 minutes left. Let's see. Yeah. That's a good idea. We shouldn't already tell the results unless the race isn't finished. Nuschel with the half-second penalty. Must have collected it in the Schumacher race, or maybe in the chicane before the left to the Nordschleife. Octavian after the pit stop, 30 seconds behind Nuschel. Eddie has been overtaken by Poctavian. Does he have damage? No. Still good. And now it's a 1.5 second penalty for Nuschel. What did he do? Where did he get another penalty? Yeah, the tires of Magix, they look horrible. He needs to go for the three-stopper. Philipp Piel, Super GT, lass fliegen. Ja, das macht auch. His whole town was killed via internet. Yeah, that's unfortunate, of course. So nothing against Flash. Yeah, I didn't say anything against him. But of course, if the whole town has no internet anymore, that's very unfortunate. Mark X going wide. Has lost quite a bit here on this turn. What are these lap times? Yeah, they are pretty good. 8 minutes 55 for a Super GT. Not the fastest lap that I've seen today, because Paul did drive an 8 minute 00.200 in the stint before. But we also need to consider Super GT did this lap in a five lap stint, or in a planned 5 lap stint. Then Sakura with the 801.980, also very fast. Unfortunately, RX lost a lot of time with when Peachy was driving, not because Peachy would have been is a bad driver, but more because he was involved in many incidents, many of them not his fault. Yeah, Paul cannot drive the same lap times anymore as Super GT and Sakura. He's 10 seconds behind these two drivers. And tire wear really doesn't look good. The front tires are already shredded. So yeah, Paul definitely on the three stop strategy. Dennis as well. So these tires look a lot better. Then Rotec saving. He wants to go for these 5 laps. Well, Super GT, or was it Enzo? I think Enzo said that we will see the sub 8 minute lap time in this race. So now we have to hurry up, because this is the last chance to... my god, this is the last chance to see the sub 8 minute lap time. So tell Super GT to drive faster. Schäfer now in a P6, and Magix, oh my god, look at this tire, look at both front tires, look at the rear tires. This Chevrolet is munching through these tires with great speed. I think for Magix it would have been better to just drive a 3 lap stint in the first stint, and then go for 4 lap stints. Because as you might know, the second set of tires is much more durable, because it isn't heated up as much as the first set. The first set may have about 90 degrees Celsius, and now Magix has gone wide. Also, I've been pushed a bit wide by Charles, or at least he needed to give room to allow Charles through, and through to this went off. If Markix does want to have a look at this incident, or wants to let it investigate further, then he needs to send this to the stewards. Super GT has gone into the pits, as well as Paul GT. This is surprising. This is very surprising. I thought that Super GT might want to go for a 5 lap stint, because this would be the easy thing to do. But now we have Rotec and Sakura for one less pit stop. Oh! What happened here? Sakura has damage now. And if you look at the... yeah, this must have happened earlier in the lap. Must have happened in the lap before. Seems to be light damage. Rotec isn't really gaining on him. But Rotec is looking more on fuel. Now we have Charles in P3. Super GT has emerged in front of Nuschel. And yeah, the lap times of Charles with the 8.16, then 8.11, 8.11, 8.14. Lap times are okay, at least if you want to go for a two-stop strategy. But we can see that the FT1 isn't very good on saving fuel and loses a lot of performance in trying to do that. This is something where the Supra GT500 is much less severe. You can shift much earlier and you don't lose that much of pace. So I was able to go the same lap times but with one more lap to go, with one more lap of fuel. Super GT wants to get past, but does not find a way around Charles at the moment. For Super GT, if he wants to maintain the lead and gain time back on Paul, he needs to get past Charles quite soon. As for Charles, if you look at the results or at the... if we look at the gaps. Oh, Super GT now on the inside. Yeah, Charles lets him go. This is smarter. This is a smart thing to do. Charles has a 8 minute gap to Eddie. So he's 8 minutes behind Eddie and 1.5 minutes in front of Octavian. So yeah, Charles does not need to risk anything. Whereas RC1 can only win one position. And this can happen if they are 1 minute 20 in front of Mark X. So so Nuschel is on a good way at the moment. He's going for the two-stop strategy. Paul has fallen back quite a bit. 10 seconds behind Nuschel and about 15 seconds behind Super GT. Then Poctavian, 7.5 seconds behind Paul. Now on a similar strategies. Dennis has also pitted, has fallen back behind Poctavian. Then Eddie in P9. 1 minute 02 behind Sakura. The gap will close down again once Sakura pits, once Rotec pits. Then Schaefer. Another 10 seconds behind, and Magix. 6.5 seconds behind Schaefer, and hopefully his long stint with the tire problems has now been done, and with the next one he won't have as many problems. with a little slide around the corner. And Sakura still has damage, but did not lose out that much to Rotek. Rotek came close for about 2 seconds, whereas Sakura is now 5 seconds behind his personal best. Rotek, very calm and collected. Was hat Gott damit zu tun? Ich habe nichts von einem. Ich denke nicht, dass ich da irgendwas gesagt habe. Vielleicht habe ich es einfach so als Redewendung angewendet, aber. Maybe it was just a saying. That sound is amazing from the Mazda. Yeah, rotary engine. Obviously, sounds different to other auto engines. Sakura will go into the pit in this lap. Still has a considerable amount of fuel left. Ist schon lange her mit dem Gott. Ja, dann weiß ich nicht, wo ich das gesagt habe. Ich kann nur so viel sagen. Ich bin selber Atheist, von daher. Wenn ich etwas mit Gott sage, dann ist das eher eine Redewendung. Und nie ernst gemeint. Anyway, Sakura and Rotek now both in the pits. They will refuel to the brim. And go for another 5 laps. Super GT now closing in. He has committed himself to the 3 stopper now. And here we see both Nuschel and Charles pitting. Nuschel has been able to overtake Charles, as it seems. Now Octavian flying by. And we hear Sakura exiting the pit. On the same level as Poctavian. Poctavian lets him by, whatever. That's not go into a fight with his TSR mate. Dennis closing in a P5, 3 seconds behind Poctavian, and Rotek came out 4 seconds behind Dennis. In front of Eddie, who is 13 seconds in front of Schaefer, and 4.5 seconds in front of Magix. Nuschel fell back to position 10 behind Magix, and Charles fell down even further. But once again, they are on one less pit stop, so the strategies will revert in the last half hour. Which, of course, means if they don't make any mistakes, then it will... pay off. Charles takes a bit of a... bit of stones with him, bit of grass from the Schumacher S. Now the first few laps with the tires are crucial because again the new set is considerably colder than at the beginning, and in my stints at least it was like that the second, the first set of tires that you took from the pits, the second set that you are driving in the race, is also considerably colder than the others, or at least has much less grip. And here we see Nuschel losing the car and getting front damage right after he exited the pits. That's unfortunate. This could now really harm his strategy. Magix, of course, will be happy because he has now a bit of a gap to Nuschel and can maybe save position 10. Well, let's look at the front again. We have Super GT 12 seconds in front of Paul. So for some reason the pit stops of Paul and Super GT were considerably shorter than for... Okay, yeah, Sakura still had damage, drove a full lap with damage, and obviously lost a lot of time also due to repairing of the damage. So yeah, that stint unfortunately is a bit less interesting considering strategies. Is stint 7 the last one? Yes, Skylight Race, this is the last stint, and it has been shortened from 3 hours to 2 hours because we are having a delay of about 40 minutes. So we thought that we need to adapt the racing time and make the race 1 hour shorter than we plan to be within the 24 hours. Italian cheeses, yeah. Sakura, Poctavian and Dennis quite close together, only within 4 seconds. Sakura, of course, with a different strategy, he's on the 2-stop, whereas Poctavian and Dennis are both on the 3-stop. Rotec driving a quiet race. Here we have Eddie. The tires don't look that well, considering he pitted in lap 2, so it can be understood why the tires look like that. It's a 4-lap stint, and due to being late morning, we still have pretty high temperatures already. So tire wear is considerable. It was also considerable in the early morning stages in stint 6. At first, the tires did degrade much slower, and the longer the race went, the more the tire did degrade, and the faster they did degrade. So Eddie will go into the pit in this lap, I believe. Yeah, I don't believe, I know that he will go into the pits in this lap, because otherwise he would be having a hard time returning to the pits with only driving 80 kilometers an hour. This would not be fun. This would absolutely not be fun. And he will probably be driving a 25-minute lap if that happens. Seven tenths adrift of his fastest lap time, which is 8.086, achieved in the lap before. So yeah, Eddie in the pits. Let's look at the Magix. He will be driving another two laps. Now, Schaefer with damage. Must have collected in this lap. Then you have Charles. And Charles here. And Nuschel continues on with the stint. He has lost a bit of time on Charles. He's now 5 seconds behind him, but obviously it seems that the damage on the front is less important than strategy, so maybe he will pit in this lap and then go for 2 4-lap stints, who knows. Or he will just continue and go for the 2-stop. Yeah, this will be interesting to see. Eddie now back on track. And we now have the sub 8-minute time. Super GT with a 7:59.649 and is half a second up again. He gives this library a proper introduction. Super GT took fastest lap of the race from me. Wow. Im Training hat mich immer nach Tipps gefragt und war 2-3 Sekunden langsam. Jetzt sowas. Was nimmt der für Zeug? Kann man das irgendwo kaufen? Auf dem Schwarzmarkt vielleicht? No, seriously, this is a very good lap of a Super GT, a 7:59.6, and he can go even faster than this. It's just such a shame that FGR had this disconnect in the 6th lobby, because they were looking great to have a win here. Or at least a podium, and now with this disconnect, the podium is... Yeah, maybe it's not out of reach, but it's a very difficult task right now. Immer diese Leute, die Sandbank. Der wird noch schneller, wenn kacken muss. Bruh. So he gets even faster when he has to take a shit. Yeah, then I will probably also race faster to go faster to the toilets. Yeah, Paul with an 11 second gap to Sakura. Tire wear doesn't really look better on this set. He's now in lap 7 and the tire looks even worse than in the first stint. I thought it would be the worst in the first stint, but obviously Paul somehow manages to use this tire even more than the other one. Has he set up brake balance maybe? Does he has it in the front or... Sakura with more fuel and much better tires is following. He's on the two stop, not like Super GT and Paul who are doing the three stopper. We will see in the end which strategy is faster. Sakura already lost about 10 or 15 seconds through the damage, so he could be right on the arse of a Paul GT or even in front of him. How is the gap between Dennis and Rotec? Dennis is 33 seconds behind Super GT and is 6.5 seconds in front of Rotec. Although it needs to be said that Dennis is on a different strategy than Rotec. Rotec is on the two-stop strategy. He will pit in lap 10. And Dennis is on the three-stop strategy. He will pit in either this lap or in the next one. Now we see yellow flags. I wonder why these were shown. Paul got damage. This could be a reason. Yeah, that's probably his first mistake in three stints. So, can happen. And luckily for Paul, he is on three-stop strategy anyway, so it won't cost him that much time. He can now go for 2-4 lap stints. But yeah, during the whole stint it was visible that Paul is not feeling as comfortable as in the stint before. And now his other side is also damaged. He's a controller driver, so... Oh, Eddie has left the room. What has happened here? Eddie has left the room. Schaefer has damage, Charles is a bit in front of Schaefer, Mark X. Has done the personal best lap time of an 8.091. And now can't reproduce this lap because it's 4 seconds slower. Oh no, what happened to... What happened to Eddie? Maybe we can look in the chat and see what happened. Oh, disconnect. Okay. That's sad. But you know, maybe it will probably not cost you that much because the gap to DLL is quite big. Paul now in the pits, wants to repair the damage and change the strategy. Now 2 more 4 lap stints. Whereas Poctavian needs to refuel much more. Tires did last for 4 laps. just about. Paul now repairing the damage and has left the pit. Comes out in front of Magix. Magix, of course, will not be any danger. There we have Charles. Poctavian came out right behind Charles. This is for position. But I guess that Charles and Poctavian won't fight that much with each other. If one of them sees that the other is faster, they will just let each other by. Poctavian goes on the inside, Charles lets him go. Does not fight him. Nusche seems not to be much slower with the damage. He's done an 8-12. He seems to be a bit slower, but not by much. Then Jeff, 43 seconds behind, has changed tires and is on a new set. So yeah, let's we have had a disconnect in every stint, or at least not a disconnect, but either someone who has given up, or someone who didn't drive or couldn't drive. We have had everything here. The race time was about 57. It's an unintentional DNF. Completed laps for 6. That's about 48 minutes. That means it must have been at the very end of the lap. And makes sense, of course. The gap to the leader was 43 seconds. 42 seconds. So yeah, lap time must have been about 7:30 or something. Let's say that. All right. And in the end, then we can report the gap properly. But again, probably won't cost as much, and because it's a 2-hour stint, it will be less costly than with a 3-hour stint. Nusche with a half second penalty has collected it somewhere. Charles is 5 seconds in front. Really seems not to be too happy with the strategy that he needs to go for the two-stop. This slows the car down quite massively. Magix, tires look considerably better than in the stint before, not by much. But a good amount, so that they hopefully won't be dead at the end of the lap. Zwei Kilo bringen eine Sekunde, sage ich ja, jetzt ist er abgehoben. Immer dieses natürliche Recycling. Dann würde ich ja glatt vorher das Motoröl ablassen. Ab auf die Hebebühne, Deckel hoch und laufen lassen. well. Back to topic, Paul, 1.12, 1 minute 12 behind Super GT. Of course, Super GT is on the same strategy, so Super GT will need to pit in this lap. 7:59.6 is fastest lap, followed by 8 minute 8, which is also very fast. Sakura is 30 seconds behind. He's not on the same pace as a Super GT, but of course on a different strategy. He only needs to pit once more. Super GT needs to pit twice. Then Dennis, 10 seconds behind, is also on the two stop. He will need to pit in this lap. Then Rotec, 4 seconds behind. Doesn't take any risk. 30 second gap to Paul GT. And yeah, let's look at Magix. His tires won't last too long, but they last at least a bit longer than before. Magix lets Octavian through. They are not really fighting against each other in the standings, so it doesn't matter here. Charles, 5 seconds behind Magix. Then Nuschel, 5 seconds behind Charles. And Schaefer again, 43 seconds behind Nuschel. Super GT now in the pits. Refueling. Sakura is coming over the line and will take the lead for the moment. Dennis also comes to the pits like expected. Super GT is coming out 14 seconds behind Sakura and 1 second in front of Rotec. So Rotec has now been cleared even when they pit together. Dennis also in the pits. Paul now back in P4. Only needs to pit once more. The gap to Super GT is 14 seconds plus 15. It's about 27 or 28 seconds. It's 29. Okay, it's 29 seconds. Octavian, 8 seconds behind Paul. He also needs to go into the pits once again, but that was due to damage. Dennis is 8 seconds behind Octavian. Ehrenmann Magix. Well, Rotec needs to come in lap 10, while Super GT needs to do it later. Let's see, Rotec looks like keeping it safe. Yeah, definitely. Charles 1 second behind Dennis. But Dennis has already pitted, so they are in the same position now. Nuschel now losing more time to Charles. I'm glad it's only a bit more than 50 minutes now, because I'm dead. I have no energy left. I think a week of 50 plus hours a week working, plus then organize this event, has taken its toll on me. Mark X has gone into the pits. He has taken fresh rubber and is 33 seconds behind Nuschel. For Nuschel, it's not enough to get past him, because the gap would need to be 1 minute 20 second plus. Which won't happen just like that. And in the last position we have Schaefer, 7.5 seconds in front of Magix. Okay, let's look at the lead again. Comfy, even though I am busy doing something else. It's court. You mean you want to co-commentate? Okay. Right. Lipsy. Yeah, anyway.
Oh. Hello.
Hi, Flipsy.
You said you're dead, so let me help out.
Oh, Sakura with a little drift, he's taken a bit of grass. I would say that you also join the lobby, and then we can both look at the, like, at the race.
I just stay out of the lobby because I do not want to interrupt anyone.
Okay.
Like or something similar. There has been some kind of nuts. I've heard from other drivers that when somebody joined the lobby, they had a frozen screen or something similar. I don't want to risk it. But nevertheless, I think after nearly 24 hours in today's race, I think we can say it was another beautiful, wonderful event that we've had. Super fast and reliable drivers. Especially, I'm impressed by the old Supra that your team has been driven. Didn't even think that we're going to make it, or going to make it into the first split. I thought you were going to race on the second, but your pace proved me wrong. And especially what I've seen from all of you, even though that you didn't race in stint one due to some specific reasons. Very, very huge fair play to you. Huge fair play to all of you guys. We could maybe need some more helpers to organize events like this. But I think that's a different type of discussion we need to do somewhere else.
Yeah, the problem in the first stint was that there was a miscommunication in the times. I don't know if Slimmy, our reserve driver. The problem was that neither me, Shishi, or Nuschel could drive in stint one, because Nuschel had school, I had a course, and Shishi needed to work. Top is working as well, so nobody could drive in this stint. We see that Super GT is now pushing it a lot and is doing considerable amount of mistakes. Yeah, anyway, then we taught Slimmy that he should drive stint one, and I don't know, he thought that the lobby would be at 2 o'clock British time instead of Central European time, so he was 1 hour late.
That's unfortunate, even though I think we always discuss times in CEST, so Central European time, I think. All I can say is it's unfortunate, it's unlucky. But you remind me of someone that wanted to throw races away if it didn't work. Always keep driving, never give up, and just continue the grind. And I think you proved it pretty well with your team indeed. No matter how much communication or organization has been needed meanwhile. Talking about the race, we haven't seen any rain, which is quite interesting. Although we haven't seen any rain, I think the grid is almost clear. All of the cars are going to pit one more time, and you will see then how the people will split up again, because Rotec needs to pit same as Sakura in this lap, I think, so they're going to continue to drive 5 lap stints. Charles as well, and I think that Super GT, Paul, Octavian, Dennis, Noshal, and Magix, same as Schaefer, will also pit in lap 11 maybe.
Noshal will definitely pit in this lap, lap 10.
Yes, he's also doing 5 stints.
He's doing a 2-stopper. The Supra is considerably better on a 5-lap stint than a 4-lap stint. It does not use that much fuel. It's also good on tires, but I'm gotta be honest, gotta be brutally honest here, I'm quite happy to discard that car as soon as the event closes, because I'm not a big fan of this car on this track. It's just what should I say, it's too hard. It's the suspension is too hard to use it on this track, because it's too low. It just takes every bump, and if you take it the wrong bump, the car just spins. And also, if you try to accelerate, it can sometimes happen that you have wheel spin, even though you don't really know why.
Reminds me of the Toyota 86 in the Group 4 class, that taking every bump will kill you. Well, it's PD. Maybe they're going to fix it anytime soon, because I don't know, if you need to watch out for every freaking curb, you might die every turn you take. I don't know if it's the point of having cars in the game which aren't drivable.
Or maybe PD will just being PD and will make the strong cars even stronger and the weak cars even weaker.
It's like a quote from today's society.
You mean like the rich get richer and the poor get poorer?
Exactly. Nevertheless, talking about richer being richer, I want to once again commit for the livery of the day competition, which is going to continue next weekend. We already had 57 people voting, and you still have a lot of people that can vote. Currently, GTF is leading with all their cars. So in case you want to vote for the most favorite livery of the day, you have up to 3 votes. We'll post you the link in the chat again. Choose your 3 most favorite cars. due to lag from the design, to appreciate the deliveries that have been made. And let's see who's going to win this.
Yeah, and just please be fair and don't vote on your own libraries or of the libraries of your own team. Be fair and appreciate the other libraries. Personally, I never vote for an RRC library because, yeah, it's our library. I don't want to.
Yeah.
I just want to support the others, and I think I have voted for the library of DLL1 with the Poctavian.
Mm-hmm.
That's surely one vote. I think I also voted for GTA and maybe also for FGR. I'm not sure.
If you want to know, I voted for the 99 Supra, the Falcon livery. I also voted for Verbman Motorsport, who's going to show their car next week. I also think that this car might be favorite to win this next weekend. And I also voted for Eric's because I like to see that they're bringing back their black and gold livery, which they always used to drive. So those are my three favorites.
That's a
good. The DLL liveries, obviously.
That's a good choice of liveries, I would say. Although I need to be fair, I don't really like the RRC liveries. Not because the Falcon livery would be not fitting. I think the Falcon livery looks good. I'm just not a fan of this coral or of this red tone. I'm not a fan of it, not at all. Nushu wanted to even use lighter color, which reminds more of Rosa.
We need more pink, like Bosworth did in Watkins Glen. We need more pink.
That this livery won the livery of the day is it's just meme factor. It was only chosen because it's so ugly, not because it's beautiful.
It's just, those things can only happen here in this series, and I'm quite proud of it. That we can enjoy this much of fun, and by all seriousness and curiosity, we can make fun of these kind of stuffs. No, but honestly, I think looking into next year, into the next season, if we somehow get the main issues managed, maybe get more people involved in organizing and helping out, I think this could be more easier to do. Let us maybe come back to the race and quickly go through everyone. Sakura is leading, going to pit this lap.
Yes.
Super GT will stay out and beat. Sakura a little bit of drifting out of the last corner.
Super GT continues. Then we have Road Tech, who will pit as well.
Yeah. OGT in P4 has got damage.
No, he has had damage, but he has repaired it. And now he's driving without damage.
Octavian, 3 seconds behind Paul. Gonna get interesting if he will be able to catch him until the end of the race. Which might be possible. Also on a very fast lap. Quite impressive to see this lap after him having a 3-hour kart race in real life and driving two other races the night before. I'm quite impressed by the driving skills that we have from all those people. if it's Noschel, if it's Super GT, if it's Paul, if it's Enzo Ferrari, if it's Octavian, Sakura, Dennis, Rotec, take whoever you want. I think that we reached a kind of driving skill level that is pretty high if it comes to the top class. Just remembering ARC back in Lago Maggiore.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Seeing someone in the chat, I'm quite surprised. Do you remember the last 24-hour race at the Nordschleife, where we were racing in GT Sports and we had a BMW versus FT1 battle? One of the BMW drivers is now in the chat. It's Helipower. Hallöchen. Schön, dass du einschaltest, Großer.
War das dann nicht das vorletzte? Das vorletzte 24 Stunden auf dem Nürburgring? Ich dachte, wir hätten da schon zwei gehabt. Das ist jetzt das dritte. Oder liege ich da falsch? Also beim 24-Stunden-Event, da hatten wir keinen FT1, weil wir da nur echte Autos verwendet haben. Im letzten Nürburgring 24 Stunden. Da wurden dann auch...
dass das komplett an mir vorbeigegangen ist. Aber ich glaube nicht.
Vielleicht war es ein, keine Ahnung, ein 12-Stunden-Nürburgring-Rennen. Dann könnte es schon sein.
Ich meine, wir sind nur 24 Stunden gefahren auf der Strecke.
Nein, wie gesagt, ich denke nicht. Ich denke, das eine Mal sind wir ein 12-Stunden-Rennen gefahren, dann das nächste war ein 24-Stunden-Rennen. Das war eben mit beschränkter Autowahl. Das war dann auch mit der Gruppe 4. Und also das erste Rennen, das 12-Stunden, war dann nur mit Gruppe 3. Da konnte man jeden wählen. Und dann das zweite, das 24-Stunden-Rennen, war dann eben Multiclass. Das haben nämlich ich, Nuschel, Shishi und Top in der GT4-Klasse gewonnen. Während in der GT3-Klasse die...
Stimmt.
Die vier lustigen 5 gewonnen haben.
Ich hätte nichts dagegen, wenn wir irgendwie GT4 fahren würden, so als Special Event oder so, als Testrennen. Mal auszuprobieren, also hätte ich da auch nichts gegen. Aber wir müssen einfach mal gucken, wie sich das organisiert, ob wir dafür Zeit und kompatible Kapazitäten haben. Ich bin auch schon fertig. je nachdem, wie sich es anbietet, was da geplant wird, schauen wir mal, was wird.
T300 geht kaum noch und meine Pedale sind nicht kompatibel in Fanatec. Ja, das liegt am Thrustmaster. Thrustmaster ist scheiße. by the way, let's switch back to English again, and we see Paul, GT and Poctavian very close together.
GT is struggling throughout the last part of his stint.
Yeah, he has a high tire wear. I don't know if Paul already did switch back the brake balance to the rear, because you need to do that with the most FR cars. But Paul is on controller, so he's incredibly fast, but problem is that he has a a lot of tire wear.
Paul is driving with a controller.
Yeah.
My goodness. That's impressive.
And yeah, I was driving in stint 6 and he did 8 minutes 02.
Yeah.
And I mean 002, also, yeah, 8 Minuten 002. Then behind these two BRZ drivers, we see TSR Sakura. He has already completed his strategy and now only needs to go to the end. Then we have Dennis, 11 seconds behind Sakura. He needs to pit once more. Will probably be in lap 12. Then we have Rotec, who has also finished his strategy. Another 46 seconds behind Rotec, we see Magix, which also will pit in lap 12. The Chevrolet Corvette with a lot of tire wear also goes a bit wide here in this corner. Takes a bit of grass, hopefully for the next few corners this won't bite him, because once the tires are dirty it will be difficult to steer the car. But Magix sees no problem. Then another 8 seconds behind we see Charles, who has completed his strategy. You were driving the FT1 as well. I don't think you were pretty happy with the car.
Be quite honest, the FT1 is completely different to what it has been in GT Sports. The car is incredibly difficult to drive. It has an issue that, for me personally, you see that Charles and Vegeta have been driving with traction control on. I tried it without traction control and had to pay quite heavy. The car originally is a complete grip monster. It is known that it maybe understeers a little bit, but it is easy to drive. It has grip in every corner, and with the game now changing its physics a bit, that you can lose grip while overheating tires, while having a little bit of dirt on it, or simply the track temperatures being a little bit lower, the car feels completely different. And I would say that the car is good to drive, but I would say it's a complete mid-tier car. So it is pretty solid if the best cars are taken. I would say that the FT1 back in GT Sports was the DLL car, especially from Charles and me. But I wouldn't take it one more time. It has an issue that if your tires overheat pretty quickly, you haven't got any force feedback in the wheel. I'm driving with the Thrustmaster T300 RS GT. So usually I would have had more force feedback than in a Logitech. But even though I have set my parameters for the force feedback pretty low, I can still feel a lot with every different car. If it's the BRZ McLaren, if it's Toyota Supra, whatever. The difference is with the FT1 that you're going to have a lot of problems with grip if your tires overheat, or you lose grip through track temperature, whatever, which makes the car completely undrivable. It's very, very hard to control, very hard to drive. So I wouldn't take it one more time, compared or looking into the future races. If we look into the next races, let's say Interlagos, WEC, Multiclass, in October, 6 hours, if I'm correct. 10 hours Suzuka, GT3 series again, the last race for the GT series, 10 hours as well. And December, a 24 hour race at Daytona, again multi-class, the last race of the season. For Suzuka, I want to do something special with it, and I don't know if some of my teammates want to do it as well, but I am looking to take a car as you did now, which isn't competitive at all, which is rarely seen on screen, but deserves some love and appreciation. I'm not going to say what car it is, but it is It could be a Mercedes SLS, it could be a BMW Z4, it could be an M3, it could be an older Nissan, it could be the old Toyota that you are driving, it could be a Ford GT, the older one. It could be everything. But it's maybe a small special I want to put at the end of this year, of the season, to celebrate the hard but beautiful year that we had.
That sounds like a good idea. Yeah, when we're talking about your car, I can also tell a story about the Supra. Why I'm not happy with the car. I had to drive the night stint, and I realized that the night stint is the worst stint that you can drive in this car, because there are many cars that are overheating their tires and have atrocious tire wear. The Supra is the exact opposite. The problem now was that the tires were too cold, and due to this I couldn't get any temperature up in the tires and was understeering everywhere, had to drive slowly, and yeah, in theory I should have driven more aggressively to heat up the tires more, but I wanted to drive with my usual driving style, which is not that aggressive. It's a very smooth driving style with a little wheel motion. So it was really difficult to heat up those tires, and only where the night was going and the morning was arriving, the car was getting faster and better. But the night stint itself, the first 2 hours, were just pure horror.
I want to know how it feels to drive with cold tires. Yeah, before we continue talking, I want to switch up to the BRZs that are fighting, I think. Octavian and Paul.
Yeah, Paul is now in P5. 1.2 seconds in front of Poctavian. Both have about the same amount of fuel. Poctavian has a bit more. And they should both be going to the end quite easily. The gap to Super GT is 1.5 minutes, but Super GT needs to pit once again. And the gap from Super GT to Sakura is 47 seconds, so once he pits he will lose about 30 seconds and the field will then be close together again. But as for now, Super GT will still need to pit, Dennis will need to pit, and from the guys behind, I think, yeah, Schaffer needs to pit once more. Unless he wants to do a 5-lap strategy. So yeah, still 1.3 seconds between both BRZs. I'm also looking forward for the event next week, the next 24-hour event. This time I will not be driving. I'm quite happy that I don't need to drive that shitbox of a Toyota again. And yeah, let's then see how the other teams perform. I was quite impressed how the Porsche team from Weltman Motorsport performed. I think both, was it King Rowan and Paul?
Yeah, Paul Duprenta. Paul was freaking fast in the Porsche.
Yeah, Paul was very good. had a pretty competitive pace, and I thought they legit have the pace to be in lobby one. I just think they made a little bit too many mistakes and missed out by a few seconds. But this at least then means that they are that they are a team to count on for the second race and maybe for the podium. For those wildcard drivers and other teams that haven't registered for the race yet, you can still register for the 24-hour race next week, or you can still register reserve drivers or whatever you want. If we get more than the 10 teams that are planned, we are happy with that. We can get up to 14 teams.
Yeah, which would be quite interesting to see the number of cars are trying to attend if someone disconnects. It would be interesting to see even new teams driving there. Talking about the next events, Confi on this question. Are you going to participate for all three races that are left? So for Interlagos, Suzuka and Daytona?
Yes, that's the plan. Obviously, for the WC events, I really need to take part because I have a Ferrari.
Yeah, that's true.
So I can drive. I can drive my own setup. And also we are pretty good in the championship right now, and we are in a good position to finish either on top or at least in the top two. And yeah, I want to perform well with the car and finish the season in style. And for the Suzuka race, I'm looking forward to that as well, because it's a racetrack that I like a lot. But this time I will probably choose my own car and not listen to Nuschel, because the cars Nuschel did choose for this race, they got collective negative feedback. Although the BRZ is very good performing, and especially Paul, but also Mega L and Mugen performed well with that car, but Knight Rider was absolutely not convinced in the car. And was not happy to drive it, and unfortunately that did cost us a chance for a win, because of him not being happy with the car, not being able to extract everything out of the car. And that's okay.
I think it's a little bit sad that Knight Rider wasn't able to finish his stint, although it might be very frustrating. Chances of your team completely blown away, but maybe there were other issues, maybe some technical failures or whatsoever.
I can only say what I always say, and that is just to finish the race, because it doesn't really matter how often you crash. You need to have a really, really shit race to be slower while driving than giving up and having a 110% time put on you for the rest of the stint.
When I can come back to the question I asked you about participating in the next three races or the last three races, and mentioning the special thing I have planned for Suzuka, I won't participate for either Interlagos or Daytona. Daytona, I just completely dislike the track, and 24 hours would be very frustrating for me, so I have the position to say now that I can leave my seat open and someone else will gladly take it. And if not, we'll just register one team less. The thing is that throughout the last performances I had, Road Atlanta, now Nordschleife, and general looking at my recent races, beside Watkins Glen, which worked really well, I just need a break. Not because I've been driving too much, but my performances have been pretty bad recently, and I feel it in myself that I just need the break. I need to do something to find myself back, if you understand what I'm trying to say. Suzuka is going to be a highlight because I want to do something special, just drive for me and myself, and maybe there are some others who also join the idea of doing something special to celebrate this series in a beautiful way. But I aim to stream Interlagos completely, the 6 hours in one take. And if we do multiple lobbies, let's say two at the same time, one lobby would be fixed because I could host it as well if my internet keeps working like it does now. So in types of organization, this would be fixed.
Yeah, that's cool as well. Now when we're looking through the field again, we can see that Super GT is now 5 seconds in front of Sakura. It's only 15 minutes and yeah, now 15 seconds left in the race until the 2 hours are reached. Super GT 5 seconds in front of Sakura, and Sakura is another 25 seconds in front of Rotec. Then we have Paul GT, 23 seconds behind Rotec, followed closely by Poctavian, who wants to be the better BRZ driver in this stint. Dennis has pitted and has done his strategy as well. He's now in P6, 13 seconds behind the pairing of both BRZ drivers. Charles, 1 minute 38 behind Super GT and 32 seconds behind Dennis. Then Nuschel with damage, front right damper. Not really a good stint for, not really a good race at all for RC1. Then we have GTF3 with Magix, who is a 2 minute 10 behind Super GT and 12 seconds behind Nuschel. And Schaefer has a really bad race. He seems to drive with the auto mode now. And it's 4 minutes. Yeah, seems to be the autopilot. And it's 4 minutes 14 behind Super GT and 2 minutes behind Magix.
Clouds. It's going darker and darker every single time. Could we see some rain?
I don't know. Because it got dark in the last stint as well several times, but there was no rain at all.
Yeah.
It's pretty interesting to me that really no rain at all is coming, because in the other 24-hour races we had, both Spa and Le Mans, they had wet weather conditions.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's really strange to see that, especially on the Nürburgring, which is known for its brutal weather and for the fast changes in the conditions, that we have seen a more or less absolutely dry race. It's strange. I would have expected, especially this one, to be rain-filled, or at least to have some showers, but there was nothing at all.
Could it be that it's because of the lobby setting that we always started with the best, sunniest way?
No, I don't think this is the case.
Because I remember that when Ku hosted Lobby 4, we had rain in the practice session. And it was randomized by the issue.
Yeah, we only do set the first weather slot because it should be the same or similar to the set to the stint before. So when it was dry in the stint before, it should be dry in the first few minutes of the stint as well. And if it was wet, then obviously you change it to a wet weather condition, which is about the best or most similar to that.
Yeah.
I think it's just I think it's just bad luck that we didn't see any rain at all, or at least only in the practice sessions, and after we changed it to the first stint being dry, it just didn't want to rain. Sometimes
maybe
it can be. I would have loved to drive in the rain a bit, but it wasn't meant to be. Anyway.
Rain would have been perfect for Johnny. The Rain Master within DLL. I said it and now Vince Lee is gonna answer that because he's the biggest Johnny hype train that I've ever seen.
Yeah. But the sky looks dark. Maybe we get the rain at the end. Hang on. Yeah, possible. Johnny is God in any condition. Yeah, Johnny may be the Rainmeister of DLL. And usually I am the Rainmeister in the RRC.
What you did at the Nürburgring in a Ferrari in a rain stint was crazy. That's maybe the experience you have from driving VT Sport without ABS on. That honestly was completely crazy what you did there.
Yeah, but the first 40 minutes weren't even that good because I made so many mistakes. I just realized after 40 minutes that there is a better way to drive, and then I just went different lines and was several seconds faster at the end. So yeah, that secured us P2 in the end. It wasn't enough for Johnny and Semis to catch, but it was only 10 seconds in the end that we were apart after 6 hours. But yeah, that rain stint, that was a highlight, and it was cool to drive in these conditions. I would have just hoped that I performed even better than that, because I'm pretty sure I could have been even 20 or 25 seconds faster if I knew this before.
Can you explain why Super GT is faster even though he made a mistake?
The question is, where did he make the mistake? Did he
is it Mühlenbach? Or Ex-Mühle?
It could be the wind direction, because the wind is blowing to the east direction, and if you are driving in this section, you obviously are a bit faster because of the wind. And now if you are as soon as we are going into this section, of course you will have a bit more downforce in the corners, which is useful in the technical section, but will kill any momentum on the straights, and you could be half a second slower because of the wind. Who knows? The wind direction and strength changes every few seconds. So no lap is the same. And yeah, this time maybe in the first part of the race, in the first part of the circuit, the Super GT was faster because of the tailwind. And now, with the wind blowing on the straights, he might lose that time that he won again.
Yeah. Talking about losing and winning, let us go to P4, I think, because Boctavian and Paul are battling pretty hard.
Yeah, Boctavian has gone past Paul.
Boctavian also having very solid lap times.
Yeah, he needs to... he's also fighting a bit for positions, I believe, because when we look at the standings of the him for next stint...
The BMW, so they could pass them as well.
Eddie has the team of GTF1 has an 8-minute 27 gap to Charles and a 10-minute gap to Boctavian. So I don't think they will. It will not cost that much, I guess. So yeah, maybe they take about 3 minutes or 4 minutes out of this, but you see it's still 8 minutes difference, so it will be difficult to get out of this. Also interesting is that FGR is taking a lot of time off Paul. Paul made a mistake again. You can see that he is not fit anymore. He's driving the second stint in a row, and in this 2 hour stint he's not really fit, it seems. The gap between it's just another case for us of a driver not being available, which was set for this stint. And yeah, Paul needed to, because Paul performed so well in stint 1 and stint 6, we thought he might perform like this as well in the second stint, but it seems it has taken a toll on him and he is pretty tired now. Anyway, at the moment the gap between RRC2 and FGR1 is about 1 minute 55, so he's still 45 seconds in front of FGR, so he just needs to have a good last lap and then it should be working out. Yeah, I would just like to know, maybe we can see the weather radar of at one of the cars. No, of course not. Would have been great to see. Sakura has lost track of where the racetrack is. Let's see in the replay what happened. Oh, okay. The car has just oversteered at the snap moment at the chicane on the second part and threw him off the track. Conditions now pretty dark. There's really rain coming in the last few minutes of the race, or is it just rain clouds being there but not raining at all? What do you think? Torrential rain makes a race fun. Yes. Most cases it would.
it's going to be dry throughout the end of the race.
Yeah, I guess so. It seems also to lighten up a bit again. So it was just being cloudy. Super GT will be the first one coming over the line. Or no, actually not. The AI of Schaefer will be the first one over the line. And yeah, this could bring chaos again to the whole operation. Because once Schaefer goes over the line, then the timer begins to start. And it will then be very difficult to collect the times of everyone who is driving. Otherwise, it would... Oh, Magix went wide. Or maybe it's just lagging. What I want to say is he's 2 minutes and 30 behind Super GT, so... if Super GT comes over the line, Magix would still be able to be in within the 3 minute window to finish the race. But due to Schaefer being in front with the AI driving, I don't think we will have all drivers cross the finish line. We should wait to give Super GT slipstream so that we can see 58. Can Schaefer please wait so that P1 can at least finish? Yeah, probably ask Schaefer that. Would probably not help if he isn't there.
Let us maybe appreciate one last time all the cars being on track. Super GT, the time is now over. Standing in a very, very impressive last stint. Had bad luck with the disconnect. I think FGR showing that they are a team that you always need to count with. I hope that we continue to drive in the next events. In Donados, Suzuka, and maybe even Daytona. Would be nice to see Sakura, Aries, as I said, bringing back the old livery, and also very impressive driving from the whole Aries team, in my opinion. Had a little bit of issues with the Mazda Vision. It's the only car that has issues on one special part of a track where you can lose the car completely because of the hard bumps. But all in all, I think very solid performance as well from Aries. Next up is maybe the most unexpected thing of today's race. It's Rotec driving for the DLN McLaren. I don't know if you can hear the smile on my face, but I am very, very happy for Rotec, for Zemitz, for Johnny, and for Mr. Friese. Friese, who actually is from a racing team aus Friesland, who helped out as a reserve driver and also put in a very solid stint. Zemitz, who was driving with a disease, very solid performance, and that's, I think, the key that the whole team delivered over the whole race. Keep it consistent, making no mistakes, and just having a solid, consistent pace, which rewards them the victory. Octavian the Bierzet, favorites, I think, but as Dragon Panda says, let's go, maybe go to Super GT to celebrate their stint victory. Solid performance. Congratulations to FGR for winning this stint.
Yeah, I need to note the gaps now. That's of course 0 for FGR. Then we have Sakura, crossing the line with a gap of 18 seconds.
Übrigens, Justin, nein, die Autos sind nicht schneller geworden. Beziehungsweise die waren dann noch flotter, die sind jetzt eher langsamer, aber im Vergleich zu GT Sport sind die, glaube ich, ungefähr gleich. Zwischendurch sind die mal langsamer, mal schneller. So, Rotec, now on the start finish straight. And that is the win for the DLL McLaren after 24 hours on the Nordschleife. Congratulations to Rotec Zemitz, Mr. Freezy. Johnny. Incredible performance. Octavian fourth. 1 minute and 6 seconds to P1. Also good recovery drive from him.
Then we have
1 minute 21. Unlucky at the end.
But should be enough to secure the podium, at least from the quick result at the moment. Then we have F1 Dennis, who brings the WSR team to second place. Also very solid performance. Charles, I don't know if he will make it to the end, but yeah, let's look through the gaps as long as we can. We have 201 for Charles, 202 for Charles. Nuschel 241, 246. Super GT now with the stint win. And with the fastest lap of the race, I guess. 7:59.649. What a lap. And oh yeah, I also need to enter this this result here in the gaps. Because now we can also calculate for can also calculate for Eddie. For some reason, it's only 1:50 for him. Anyway. I take it as it stands. So this would bring the unofficial result that you can see in the Google Sheet document, which I cannot show in the stream, or maybe I can, but I need to. Yeah, I would need to make a new picture for that. I'll tell it as it stands. We have DLL3 winning the stint with you say it again. Flipsy with the drivers, I mean. With the drivers.
Yeah, DLL3, Rotec, Johnny Zemitz and Mr. Freezy. I'm just so happy at the moment. I don't know.
Yeah, congratulations to these drivers for the provisional win. Then we have WSR1 with let's look at that by myself. WSR1 with F1 Dennis, MLL Milano, WSR Sander in P2. Then we have in P3 RRC, the RRC2 team with Paul GT, Mega-L, Mugen NSX, and Knight Rider. In P4, we have FGR1. What?
Just a short word from me because I have to go. Okay. Congratulations to all of the drivers for again competing in such amazing event, and thank you to everyone for participating in the most fair and special way they could have brought. GGs to everyone. I hope we will see more of those kind of races in the future. Interlagos, Suzuka and Daytona are good points where we could maybe start delivering those kind of events again. Thank you very much for everyone at the Orga for organizing and helping out in this event, especially to your Confi once again. Very solid and amazing job you did together with all the other people working in the background. I do hope there won't be much steward work to do, but I think there will be, especially through one driver, but that's something we need to discuss within the group and within the stewards, but that's something else. Nevertheless, thank you very much once again, everybody, for making this possible. Keep it clean, make sure to be loved, and enjoy yourselves. See you next time.
Yeah, see ya. Thank you for co-commentating with me and also for streaming a few stints. It was greatly appreciated.
I did what I could do. But as I said, Interlagos will be streamed from me, whole Lobby One on Twitch in October. Okay, guys, see you then. Bye bye.
Bye. So yeah, we have now posted the super mega giga provisional result of the 24 hours of Nürburgring in the Discord chat. Once again, DLL3 winning this race in front of WSR1 with a gap of 2 minute 43 and RC2 with a gap of 6 minute 19 to DLL3 finishing third. Then we have in fourth place the unlucky FGR team. Unfortunately, although they were performing very well, very fast lap times, they were just not that lucky, and unfortunately that lobby disconnect did not help them at all. Sorry for that. Unfortunately, the reliability is not always part of the game, and it's also in real life. Some cars have mechanical issues, some don't, and unfortunately for FGR, they had the technical issue while others didn't. Nevertheless, a very, very good performance of FGR. My team of the race for this event. Then we have RX1 in P5, 8 minute 12 behind DLL3. In P6 we have GTF1, 10 minute 21 behind. Then we have DLL2, 19 minutes behind DLL1, 19 minutes 50 behind. GTF2, 27 minutes 16 seconds behind. Then GTF3, 35 minutes and 57 seconds behind, and RC1 37 minutes and 12 seconds behind. Okay. I need to take a bath. I need to get clean again because I'm sweating like a pig. So yeah, see you in the next event, which will be next week, the second 24-hour event of the Nürburgring. This time with the drivers and teams from Lobby 2, Split 2. And maybe as a short introduction of who will take place, who will participate in this race, we will look at the quick result. No, that's not not, right? Yeah, let's look at time quality result. Yeah. All right. Okay. Then we would see following teams. We would see maybe if WSR can solve their issues with the wheel of Gammeltoast, they are allowed to participate in Lobby 2. So we would see WSR 2. We would also see Weltman Motorsports. We would see the Pegasus Team Esports. We would see three different Don entries. We would see GTA 1. Ah, PTE, sorry. PTE is not Pegasus. No, PTE. The PTE team in third place. Then in fourth place, we will see UN1, then GTA1, the Pegasus esports team. We will see DON2, DON3. We will see SGR1, Spider GT racing team. We will see RX3. We will see FVE. Maybe we will also see Hermann Motorsports. And if some teams want to join and want to take part in this race, they can participate, they can register, and we will allow them to enter. Anyway, that's enough for me right now. We will see you quite soon again. And yeah, have a good evening. Have a good Sunday. See ya.